know there are more girls in a church like this than they'll ever find in a club. And so they'll show up and they know the pastor has taught that you don't date unbelievers, and you don't try to win them to Jesus. You don't date unbelievers. Don't be unequally yoked with unbelievers. What do you have to do with them? What do you have in common with them? They don't know your God. They curse your God. And so these sheep are wolves in sheep's clothing will come into a church and they'll learn how to talk the talk. They'll learn how to raise the hands. They'll learn how to play the part. They'll learn how to scope the crowd and find the girls. And if you're not careful, they'll do it all in the name of Jesus, you see. Wolves in sheep's clothing.
Yes.
The spirit of the wolf just creeps in and begins to tell you, you know, it's all right. It's all right. Let's start dating. I'm a Christian. I'm a believer. But you notice you don't see the fruit. You don't see that they keep trying to do things that you know they shouldn't be trying to do. Keep trying to get you to come back to go back to your apartment all alone.
Amen.
What are you talking about? I'm talking about that wolf spirit. And before you know it, it knows, the wolf spirit knows that if it's going to defeat you, it's got to separate you from the flock and the shepherd God has put you under.
Right.
And so what they'll do is they'll say, let's not go to that church anymore. Because just when they thought they were going to get you to fornicate,
come on, tell it.
Pastor gets up and preaches, keep your underwear on. And just when they think that you're going to start going to the club again, Pastor gets up and preaches on that very thing.
Yeah.
And they start making comments like, I just don't feel comfortable there. Well, I don't guess you do. Howling at the moon at midnight. Because you're a wolf. You're not a sheep. Most wolves don't feel comfortable here. Somewhere where the truth is never preached, where conviction is never felt, where standards are never held up, where you just kind of live loose. And if you want to sleep with somebody, if you want to live with somebody, if you want to try them out, just move in together. You'll never hear anything about it from the pulpit. Everybody work out your own salvation. God is love. Wolf spirit, remember his tactic is to pull you away. Pull you away. So before you know it, you're going to his dead church.
Come on now.
No anointing, no word. Sometimes it's not just a he wolf. Say you're married. Remember, the spirit of the wolf wants to disconnect you from the relationships that God has put you in.
Come on now. Tell that.
Say you're married. Your wife's just had a baby. Everything's changed. It's rocked your world. You're not getting any attention. Everybody's gooing about the baby. Your wife don't really have much time for you right now. Y'all kind of getting on each other's nerves. And the bills are coming in. Everything's tense at the house because every marriage goes through stuff.
Amen.
And you get to the office and there's a she-wolf. To how you can recognize one. They start making comments. She starts making comments like this. I sure hope she knows what she's got.